In the previous movie, we created a name constraint to control our camera's directions towards their target. In this movie, we'll convert one of them into a third-person perspective camera constrained to servo's position. Open the level servo camera from your current project. You can also use the files provided with this movie by merging them into a new Stingray project. Start by deleting the servo clone, leaving only the original one in your level. Next, switch to your original camera and position it behind servo so it occupies the lower third of the viewport. Go to the Level Flow tab. To constrain our camera to servo, we first need to retrieve servo's position using a Get Unit World Position node. Then, connect its output vector to the camera using a Set Camera Local Position node. However, leaving this as is will result in snapping the camera to servo's pivot. We therefore need to add an offset vector to that position. This could be an arbitrary vector that we manually set, but here it makes more sense to use the camera's current position relative to servo as an offset. Open the camera aim constraint flow we created in the previous movie. We can reuse this part of the flow graph to calculate the position offset we need. Copy-paste these nodes into the Level Flow tab and reconnect them to the flow graph. Delete the original Get Unit World Position node at the same time. Duplicate the Subtraction node, and then connect the Get Unit World Position node to its A port and the position offset value to its B port. Test your level to validate your changes. Instead of following servo, the camera remains still as if it weren't constrained at all. This is caused by our flow graph's evaluation cycle. Since Stingray calculates the camera's position on every frame, the camera's position offset is updated as well to reflect the distance between the camera and its target. Instead, we want to calculate the position offset only once and then reuse that value in the following evaluations. Create a Set Vector Variable node to store the position offset. Set its name to Camera Position Offset. Similarly, to retrieve that variable's value, we'll use a Get Vector Variable node. Make sure you set its variable name to match its sister node. To trigger the Set Vector Variable node once, we could connect it to the Level Loaded node. Instead, we'll connect it to the Level Update node, but channel it through a Once node. Test your level to validate your changes. The camera follows servo as it moves around. Now that our flow graph works, let's convert it to a flow subroutine. Copy the external input unit and external in-event nodes from the camera aim constraint flow and connect them to your flow graph accordingly. Duplicate the external input unit node and rename it to camera unit in. Save your flow graph in your local script folder as camera position constraint. Return to the Level Flow tab and load your new flow into a flow subroutine node. Group the flow subroutine node by itself. Test your level to validate the changes to your flow graph. Our camera position constraint is currently independent from our aim constraint, as we may not always want our camera to aim at a target while moving. However, we can embed the aim constraint into the position constraint and then allow the user to toggle it based on the situation. Copy the camera aim constraint flow subroutine node into the camera position constraint flow graph. Next, create an external input Boolean node and set its name port to enable aim constraint in. Insert a branch node between the set camera local position and flow subroutine nodes. Connect the external input Boolean node to the branch node so only a true value will trigger the aim constraint. Save your flow graph, then return to the level flow tab and reload your flow subroutine node. You can now choose to use the built-in aim constraint if your camera requires it. Don't forget to disconnect the standalone aim constraint flow subroutine nodes before you test your level. In the next movie, we'll create a variation of this position aim constraint combo to allow the camera to orbit around servo.